Hi, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, you're welcome. Thank you for tuning in. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you for tuning back in. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. So in today's video, we are going to be making onion oil for hair growth to stop breakage and to heal the scar from any itching. Our first ingredient that we'll be using is onion. You blend it into a smooth paste. Then this is the onion you're using. You can use any type of, I'm using the red one. Then when you want to blend it, you just add a little oil, olive oil or coconut oil, just a little, just to help with the movement as you're blending it. So you blend it. I'm using this small smoothie blender. You can use any type of blender of your choice that can make it into a smooth paste. Blend, blend, blend until it's very smooth, like smoothie. So after blending, you turn it into a saucepan or a fry pan. I'm using a non-stick pan. Just put it into it, the paste or the, yes, the paste that you've just gotten from the onion. Then add your oil. I'm using 2 cups coconut oil and the olive oil for it. So you can use any oil of your choice, either coconut alone or you use olive oil alone, depends on what you want. So I'll be pouring my extra virgin olive oil, pouring like half a cup of extra virgin olive oil. Then I'll be adding like a quarter cup of olive oil, just more, because I like the combination of that. I like the olive oil to be bigger than the coconut oil, because I love olive oil. It's very good for moisturizing. Then you put it on a, you place it on your gas on a low heat and allow it to steam. Continue stirring it every 1 or 2 minutes to avoid some parts burning while others are still white. So you just have to keep turning, just to be, you can see how it's bubbling. When it starts bubbling, you know that the reason for this is just to help the water from the onion to evaporate, so that you'll be able to get all the nutrients into the oil, and then when you process the oil, it won't ferment very easily. So if the water does not evaporate, the oil will not be able to last, because there will be water inside it, and within 2 to 3 days bacteria can start forming in it. So this is how you're going to be doing it, just to, on a low heat, just for the water to escape, so that we'll get our clean oil that can last us for like weeks without the fear of getting bacteria into our hair. So once you see the thing has started turning brown, so it's slightly turning brown, then you see that it has started brown when the color of the onion have changed from white to brown, just like this, you know that it is ready. You might not fry it till this point, but once the color has changed from the original color, you know that the water has finished escaping. Then I'm using a wick cap to sieve it. You can use anything of your choice, cheesecloth, hanky, whatever you think that you can use to get all the oil out of the onion. Just like this, so use it to get it. So this is it, and you're going to process in the oil just like so. So this is very easy to make. If you don't have time to be blending oil, extracting the juice, though that one is also very active, but when you don't have time like to be doing it every time, you can just substitute it with the oil like this, or you can use this one to massage your edges, especially if you're suffering from bad edges, if you're suffering from itching, dandruff. This is also very good. You can use this to massage your scalp. You can use it, add it to your oils when you want to do your hot oil treatment. You can use it on a daily basis if you want. It is good for hair fall. It will help to grow your edges. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up. Thank you for watching. Share this video to your friends.